llegó la hora de disfrutar de su programa, Nuestra Hora con Leti. Les presento a Leti Ortiz, productora ejecutiva y conductora de este programa, lleno de alegría, entretenimiento, entrevistas, reconocimientos y mundo infantil Arizona. Nuestra Hora con Leti.
Hola, ¿qué tal, amigos? Soy Leti Ortiz, productora ejecutiva y conductora de Nuestra Hora con Leti, dándoles la bienvenida una vez más a este maravilloso programa. Y en este momento les presento a mis copresentadores, mis co-hosts.
Hi, I'm Chef Ernesto from Charlo's Steakhouse, co-hosting today.
Mucho gusto, Ricardo Morales.
Inés Ramos.
And I'm Fanny Girl.
Y como siempre les damos las gracias a todos nuestros patrocinadores principales, como lo es la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson y Leilani Chef Creations. Y por primera vez tenemos al Hotel GLH. Gracias. Y en este momento damos inicio a este maravilloso programa de
Nuestra Hora con Leti.
Amigos, les recomiendo Leilani Chef Creations con sus estilistas amables y profesionales. Y aquí nos atienden como en familia.
Leilani Chef Creations, les esperamos para darles su nuevo look. Somos expertas en alto peinados para bodas, quinceañeras, proms o cualquier evento especial que tenga usted. ¡Los esperamos!
Y como ven, amigos, ahora fue un día de fiesta. Es un día de fiesta para nosotros, un domingo hermoso, un domingo lindo, familiar, y por supuesto una gran amiga que la admiro bastante con... ¿Ven este micrófono? No es de verdad, pero lo estamos... We pretend here it's a microphone, ¿ok? So, tell me what's your name and how long you've been doing this. It's a fun stuff and parties and quinceañeras and birthdays. So, tell me your name and
Let me take the microphone then. My name's Whitney Renee. I am the owner of Pucker Up Photo Booth. Uh-huh. We have been in business for over a year now. We're doing exceptionally well. We're constantly getting booked for weddings, quinceañeras, birthday parties, corporate events, or any other kind of event you're having where you want your guests to bring something memorable home with them. So, yeah, I'll give this back.
How you got the idea to have something like this? I mean, you see here you have the camera instant. Yes. And to have the pictures in that moment, right?
Right. Well, everyone wants instant gratification when they're at events and looking for pictures. So we actually print all our pictures right here within 30 seconds of taking it. We use high quality equipment, professional cameras, professional flashes, professional printers. All of our prints are waterproof, smudge proof, fingerprint proof, and they come out within 30 seconds, so you always have something to take home. And they're completely customized to fit your event or have your company logo. However you'd like it to look, we can do that for you.
Oh, entonces muy interesante lo que hace ella con este negocio. Es divertido porque pues se presenta en todas las fiestas, en quinceañeras, bodas, birthdays.
Yes.
Oh, divorcios también puede serlo, ¿eh? Pues, ahora que son tan populares los divorcios, ella puede estar ahí presente y las fotos pues son muy buena calidad y los da en ese momento, y pues para que se lleven una foto de recuerdo, ya sea de la fiesta o ya sea de una reunión familiar, de una reunión de negocios. Entonces, lo que nos estaba explicando aquí mi amiga Whitney.
Here it comes. All right, there's one. You guys got 5 seconds if you want to switch your signs around or do a silly face. All right, here it comes. In 3, 2, look right here.
Smile, yeah.
All right. Woo! Good job, okay. Guys.
Whitney, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming to Nuestra Hora con Leti. I know it was your first time in camera, but you look
yes.
So beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you. Continuamos con más de Nuestra Hora con Leti.
El restaurante Crossroad es el más visitado en Tucson, sirviendo por más de 75 años sus tradicionales platillos mexicanos con un ambiente muy familiar. En el restaurante Crossroad cocinamos con los ingredientes y productos más frescos y nuestros cortes de carne y mariscos. Visítanos, es el lugar único y popular con sus enchiladas y tacos. Y tenemos algo para toda la familia. En el restaurante mexicano Crossroad, no te vas con el estómago vacío.
Welcome, everybody. I'm Chef Ernesto, and welcome to our show, Nuestra Hora con Leti. Today's segment is provided by GLH Hotel. It's an event center where you can go ahead and book a lot of your quinceañeras and weddings, up to 200 people. It's a great place. Get a hold with Erica at the hotel, GLH Hotel. We have some special guests today with Leti.
Yes, let's welcome our guests, Ernesto.
Definitely.
Hi, I'm Trish Devitt.
And I'm Eva Blanes.
Wonderful, wonderful.
And good what company? Oh, thank you for being here.
The company is Organo. Mm-hmm. It's a coffee business. Mm-hmm. We love it. Mm-hmm. And we're introducing a healthy, gourmet, smooth-tasting coffee to our community. The company has been around for 8 years. Mm-hmm. We are introducing it to our community right now. It is healthy, as we said, because it's infused by a natural herb called Ganoderma.
Which is very important, because a lot of things right now are very organic for a lot of health reasons for a lot of people. So having something very natural for your coffee is very good for people, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. Absolutely. And the Ganoderma infuses the coffee, takes away the bitterness, neutralizes the caffeine effects, and it makes it smooth tasting, and it's good for our immune system.
Wow. A ti que te encanta el café, ¿verdad?
A mí me encanta
este
el café.
Es orgánico y realmente eso ayuda.
Sí. Yeah, I'm Cuban, so I gotta have my Cuban coffee. So I need to get going, you know what I'm saying? When I work 16 hours a day, I need to have my Cuban coffee.
So now you get the caffeine effect gets neutralized, but you still get the energy.
Good.
So you still get fueled and
yeah.
energized.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Let's try. Nice. I'm gonna try my tea, and you're gonna try your coffee.
I'm gonna try
too.
My coffee.
Okay. So it's so easy. All you have to do is add hot water. It's gourmet.
I love
produced.
Gourmet.
Yes.
I love gourmet.
It's easy and it's portable, convenient. And it's so smooth.
Smells nice. Yeah.
Y para las personas que no toman café como yo, pues estoy tomándome un té también natural y orgánico. That's a nice taste. It's a really good taste.
Oh, yeah. I love that. That flavor right there is very robust. Mm-hmm. So a very nice, robust flavor right there.
And so you can make it as strong or as light as you prefer.
Yeah.
So I understand that you guys also helping the community local here in Tucson.
Yes. We love to recognize and appreciate and honor those who are in service in our communities. Mm-hmm. Those heroes like the firefighters, like the police officers, like the ER workers, doctors, nurses, school teachers.
That's wonderful.
Now, the Ganoderma, by the way, it's been around for over 2,000 years as the Chinese medicine.
Oh.
So it was revered as, it was called the immortal plant.
Uh-huh.
And in ancient days, only the royals were allowed to use it.
And look at us.
Could use it.
Now we're the royals.
Got it every day. Yes, we are.
Now we're the royals.
Well,
privileged.
I think you guys have to come, my ladies, come on another TV show because I see my producer, my director. My 3 minutes is almost done. But thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here. And
thank you. It's a beautiful coffee. It's delicious coffee. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
Yes.
We will need to have you again.
Yes. And we'll always bring coffee.
Yes. This is delicious. Yes. So continuamos con más de aquí, de nuestra hora con Leti.
Organo Gold Gourmet Coffee.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. ¿Estás listo para hacer crecer tu negocio? Nosotros podemos ayudarlo. Únete a la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson.
Representamos más de 1,800 empresas en Arizona y México y contamos con oficinas regionales en Sierra Vista, Douglas y ambos Nogales.
La Cámara Hispana organiza eventos sociales, talleres de educación empresarial.
La Cámara presenta talleres de compras diseñados para ayudar a su empresa a hacer negocio con el gobierno y corporaciones.
No te pierdas esta oportunidad para un mayor éxito.
Welcome again to Nuestra Hora con Leti.
Thank you very much.
Inés va a estar aquí con nosotros también ayudándonos en esta entrevista. Nos va a mostrar una receta de nopalitos con frijoles blancos.
First, I'm going to put in the nopalitos, which I picked from our yard yesterday.
Mm-hmm. Wow, you have a jar with nopalitos there?
Yes, I do. What I do is I marinate them in garlic, which is very good for you, and lemon or lime, and I do that for 24 hours. But you can do it for 2 hours if you want. Mm-hmm. And then I grill them. So I don't lose a lot of the mucilage, which is the polysaccharide fiber, which is a non-carbohydrate fiber that reduces cholesterol. It reduces the bad, the LDL, the low-density lipoprotein. Wow. And it also can help you lose weight. And it it will help keep the blood sugar down.
Una receta especial para bajar el colesterol y para bajar libras.
I'm going to put that in and put a good portion in. And then I have cannelloni beans. You can either prepare them from dry beans or you can do the from a can. So I'm going to put those in. And again, it's more fiber.
Especial para esta ensalada de frijoles con sus nopalitos. And what's next?
Okay, so I also caramelized some red beets. Okay. And there's garlic in them and balsamic vinegar. Okay. Oh. So that goes in, gives beautiful color. And it's also clears toxins from your body. So it's a great thing to have. I'm going to put a little bit of quinoa in. Mm-hmm. And this will increase the protein content.
Wow.
And then, of course, cilantro. I can't live without cilantro.
El cilantro.
And so, again, you have a lot of phytonutrients, especially in herbs. Herbs are the highest in phytonutrients.
Okay.
This is, and I got the cilantro from my backyard. And this is mint, which is also extremely high in antioxidants. Basil is not in season, but I got some.
Okay. So everything is organic because you have it in your yard.
Yes.
Oh my God, that's beautiful.
I'm going to put a little bit of kale in. Now what I did with the kale, you have to massage the kale.
Oh, with your hands.
So I literally got in here and went like this until my hands are green. This was up to here.
Wow.
So it has gone down to probably half to a third. This will take on all of the flavors. Plus, you can digest it much better than if you don't do that.
Wow.
So I'm going to put a little bit of this in. And I pretty much go on color. So let's see what the color looks like right now.
Oh, that looks so good.
And if we
deliciosa.
If we want more green, we put more green in. Now this, and I'll talk about that as I'm tossing this, that is the salad dressing. And it has sun-dried tomatoes because there aren't any fresh tomatoes, and I like tomatoes fresh out of the garden. There's also the serrano pepper. A little bit of that in there, too.
Oh, yeah.
The spicy thing, it has to be there.
Okay, in this is fresh oregano from my backyard.
I love oregano, fresh oregano.
Some garlic. Red red onion and the zest off of the lime, lemon, you call it lemon. And then I have lemon juice in here too. So there we go. We put it all in.
So it's no aderezo, no tiene un aderezo fuerte
especial.
Esto es
especial hecho en casa. No tienes que comprar de la tienda porque tú misma lo puedes preparar.
Delicioso.
Check the color out.
Wow.
Now, when you have a mix of different vegetables and herbs and beans, they act synergistically or in concert together to make it even a stronger prescription for health. So that's why I use a lot of ingredients. And they go so well together. So there you go.
avocado, el aguacate que no debe de faltar tampoco en las ensaladas para nuestra mesa mexicana, ¿verdad?
Oh. You could eat a whole avocado a day and it would be one of the healthiest things that you could do.
Ella nos obsequió dos libros de ella, de estos libros que pues traen unas recetas deliciosas, deliciosas y muy muy saludables, que es también recetas que son orgánicas y bueno, como esta ensalada de nopalitos y frijolitos. Vamos a despedirla a todos con un fuerte aplauso porque tenemos un público.
Look at this, we have an audience here and
let's have our selfies.
Okay, let's do this, yes.
Hi, this is Fanny Girl with Tejano Nation, and I'm here at the Action Harris Casino in Maricopa, Arizona, and I'm here with the two-time Grammy Award winner, Mr. Sonny Salceda. How are you feeling? Welcome to Arizona.
Well, I'm great. First of all, thank you for having me, and it's great to be on your show. Thank you so much. It's great to be in Arizona, of course, at the Harris. It's always a privilege and an honor, and you know, we're excited to be here. It's been a while since we have been here, so we're always grateful to see the hardcore Tejano fans here. I mean, This is probably as crazy as they get, and I could tell you some stories, but I will not. I'll have to do that. We'll have to do an after hours show for that.
A backstage interview?
Then you go. That's right. An after stage.
So Sonny, you play the accordion so good. How old were you when you started playing it?
Well, thank you. First of all, I've been playing accordion since I was about maybe 15 years old. I didn't like the accordion. I'm not an accordion player. I'm a bajo player, and a bass player. But I just fell into the accordion. And I was gonna play bajo sexto with Eddie Gonzalez. The guy didn't show up. I auditioned and played a polka, and the rest is history. I mean, I wasn't really an accordion player. But...
So every time I see you, you always have a different accordion. How many do you have?
Oh my gosh, several different. I don't know, maybe 10, 15 accordions. But accordions are like cars. I used to think it was cool to have more accordions, but it's just more expensive to have more accordions. So
right.
It is.
So where do you keep them?
Well, different places. I have them at home at my accordion repair guy. Just I lend them out sometimes, so it's, you know, they're like spread everywhere.
So Sonny, I follow you on Facebook, and you're always checking in everywhere. You're always performing.
I am.
You're always playing music. Mm-hmm. So what do you do in your downtime?
What is that? I don't know what downtime is. I don't have any downtime. You know, I'm really, really busy with the band, with the record label, with promoting the record label. The you know, of course, you know, the mm-hmm. Sonny Salcedo Verso brand. So I don't really know if there is any downtime. I think the most downtime I ever have is really just going to the gym. I started going to the gym again, so that's kind of like my therapy. Mm-hmm. But lately it's been consulting and gym time, so people call me, new artists that are working on their new album and want some help with direction as far as radio and, you know, what kind of marketing strategy they should choose for their single and whatnot. So, but I love, you know, when you love to do what you do, you never work a day of your life. So I enjoy
right.
it, and there's really no downtime. Hasta me regañan, you know, why are you working?
Working
stop. But I just love it. I never stop. Maybe to the movies, or you know, maybe to the river, maybe that's kind of downtime, but even then I'm kind of thinking, I'm thinking about this cool song or an idea. So, you know, I think when you're an artist, you're always kind of in work mode.
So you have a lot of dedicated fans here in Arizona, and they've been inboxing me all week long, and they want to know, what's the meaning behind your white glove?
The white glove. Well, when I first started, there was a bunch of solo artists. There was Ram Herrera, there was Gary Hobb, there was Emilio Navaira, there was Eddie Gonzalez, Roberto Pulido, Bobby Pulido. So there was a bunch of solo artists. So first of all, my intentions were never to be in the Tejano music industry. I come from the conjunto world.
Right.
I played the flea markets, the cantinas. So when I came into Tejano, I it was just to try it out with Eddie Gonzalez. I told my dad, I still played with my dad's band, but I kind of, I don't know, I had a hunch. I just wanted to have a trademark. I wanted for people maybe not to remember my name, but to remember the glove. But I didn't think about it as marketing, but that's what I did. So I kind of used that so people would remember me.
Well, tell us about your album. It got released during Fanfare, right?
Yes, we released our new album during Fanfare. It's called Dios Familia Musica. It's on Solstice Records. That's our record label. It's our fourth production, and I'm very proud of that album. Dios Familia Musica is the first single off that album, which did very, very well. It got played very heavily on all major markets and secondary markets. Got played, and I got emails from Rome, Italy, I got emails from Mexico. I got played everywhere. Well, thank you for having me. Thank you to the fans for all the support. Thank you for supporting Sunny Salceda all these years, you know, with Eddie Gonzalez, with Grupo Vida, and, you know, and now that we're doing our thing. And I say now, but it's been 12 years now, or 13 years, so we're just very grateful and blessed, and we can't thank you enough. We hope to see you in your city. If we haven't played there, you can reach us at facebook.com/Sunny Salceda. You can call us, you can book us, inbox us, and just send us a shout. You know, we'll go play. You know, believe me, if you are asking for Sunny Salceda y Todo Eso, you ask your promoters, they will listen because they know that you're going to go out to the shows, and that's what they want to hear. So, you know, request us and, you know, and go out to the show, support all the Tejano talent in our industry. Go buy the record, you know, don't download it for free. You know, that's so important. So, you know, thank you so much again, and we can't wait to see you in your town.
Well, I want to thank you for your time once again.
Thank you.
I am Fanny Girl with TejanoNation.net.
El restaurante Crossroad es el más visitado en Tucson, sirviendo por más de 75 años sus tradicionales platillos mexicanos con un ambiente muy familiar. En el restaurante Crossroad cocinamos con los ingredientes y productos más frescos y nuestros cortes de carne y mariscos. Visítanos, es el lugar único y popular con sus enchiladas y tacos. Y tenemos algo para toda la familia. En el restaurante mexicano Crossroad no te vas con el estómago vacío.
A continuación, con nuestra hora con Leti, el compromiso siempre de brindarles el talento local, lo máximo, lo más impresionante e impactante en nuestra comunidad, tenemos a otro personaje estelar. Este profesor, un profesor de la Universidad de Arizona, este muchacho egresado de la Universidad de Michigan con su licenciatura, maestría y además un doctorado, es el doctor Mo Ezzani. Vamos a platicar con él y nos va a destacar de todos los datos y sus descubrimientos, porque en verdad es un inventor reconocido a nivel mundial. Doctor, I just gave all your some of your highlights of your career and a little bit of your education, but welcome to Nuestra Hora con Leti. I did mention that we have some of the best local talent and the most impressive people in our community. So thank you. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, and my Spanish is not that good, but I realize that you said a lot of good things, and I hope I live up to your expectations.
Dice que su español no es muy bueno, pero él está consciente de que dijimos muchas cosas bonitas y va a tratar de lograr hacer el cumplimiento para todas las cosas que dijimos de él. Tell us a little bit about your beginnings in your career as a civil engineer. How did all this begin and all your inventions? Por favor, díganos los inicios en sus invención, sus inventos y su carrera.
Okay. So I'm originally from Iran. I came to the U.S. after I finished my high school in Iran, so at the age of about 18. And at that time, I went to Michigan, and that's when I started college.
Wonderful. Lo que nos dice es que él es originario de Irán. Después de su escuela secundaria fue cuando vino a los Estados Unidos y fue cuando empezó en la universidad.
And then after, as you mentioned, for about 10 years I was going to school at the University of Michigan, then I moved to Tucson in 1982 as a professor of engineering.
Muy bien. Más o menos después de 10 años en la Universidad de Michigan, vino a Tucson y ha pasado ahí 10 años en la Universidad de Arizona como profesor. Now, tell us this. Was it difficult being an immigrant? Porque some people that are watching are from Mexico, and they have goals, and they say, well, I'm not from here. Can I ever even make it? Lo que le pregunto es que si él piensa que para personas inmigrantes de México, que tal vez están viendo el programa, que si, ¿qué les puede dar de ánimo para que si lo, fue difícil o si ellos también lo pueden lograr?
Well, you know, I think I'm a living example that if you work hard, you can achieve whatever goals you really set for yourself.
Excelente. I love that answer. Dice que él es un ejemplo viviente de que si alguien trabaja lo duro suficiente, puede lograr cualquier meta que se proponga. Yeah. Thank you, doctor. Ahora, díganos acerca de, vamos a decir, su primer invento, o tal vez el más reciente. Tell us about some of your inventions, or perhaps the most recent that you would like to talk about. Okay.
So one of the things that I developed was a new way of strengthening existing buildings and bridges. And so we have, this is a carbon fabric, and we put epoxy on this and put it on the surface of a building. By the next day, this becomes three times stronger than steel.
Wow. nos está mostrando algo que él desarrolló. Dice que es algo, una composición de fibra de carbono que se lo aplican a puentes o estructuras de acero ya muy antiguas que tal vez están un poco débiles. Se lo aplican además de un epoxi y después de algunos días está 3 veces más fuerte que el acero. Wow.
So we make, repair buildings, bridges. We make government buildings blast proof for United Nations, for the U.S. Army.
Wow. Nos dice que también, además de estos inventos, están desarrollando algunas cosas y ya han desarrollado algunas cosas que son para lograr que algunos de los edificios del gobierno sean, que puedan recuperarse, o bueno, que sean, how can I say, proof, que sean contra explosivos. Yeah. Algunos, dijo que un edificio de Beirut, de Líbano, ahora lo construyeron y es contra explosivos. Así que es algo muy impresionante y muy bueno para la humanidad. Yeah. Felicidades, es algo contra terrorismo. Something that can help us fight terrorism.
Exactly.
Very, very nice, doctor. What about something else that you've done? Algo más.
This is another product that we have developed, that it is a pipe that, unlike other pipes, the wall of this pipe is hollow, so it's very light, but it is extremely strong. And then we have made an equipment where we can make, if somebody needs like 20 miles of a pipe, we can send this equipment and make one piece of pipe for them in the field 20 miles long.
Wow. El último producto que nos va a mostrar es un tubo que desarrollaron que tiene la pared hueca, pero es aún muy fuerte. Entonces, debido a que es hueco y muy fuerte, es muy ligera, no es tan pesado como otras pipas. Y por último, el invento que el doctor Esani desarrolló es algo que pueden construir una pipa o un tubo de hasta de 20 millas de largo ahí mismo donde se está instalando. Así que algo muy impresionante. Felicidades en los premios. Congratulations on your recent award. Reconocido por la Sociedad Americana de Ingenieros Civiles, el doctor Mo Esani, un orgullo local, un orgullo mundial, reconocido por todos lados y un ejemplo viviente para las personas que están viendo el programa, para los inmigrantes, personas mexicanas, latinoamericanas y de cualquier región o etnicidad que tengan, para que vean que, como dijo el doctor, in your words, doctor, cualquier meta se puede lograr si se trabaja lo duro e inteligente suficiente. Doctor, thank you for being on the show.
Muchas gracias.
¿Estás listo para hacer crecer tu negocio? Nosotros podemos ayudarlo. Únete a la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson.
Representamos más de 1,800 empresas en Arizona y México y contamos con oficinas regionales en Sierra Vista, Douglas y ambos Nogales.
La Cámara Hispana organiza eventos sociales, talleres de educación empresarial.
La Cámara presenta talleres de compras diseñados para ayudar a su empresa a hacer negocio con el gobierno y corporaciones.
No te pierdas esta oportunidad para un mayor éxito.
Amigos, ha sido todo por esta ocasión. Gracias por habernos acompañado durante 30 minutos de programa aquí en Nuestra Hora con Leti. Regalen esa sonrisa que nada les cuesta. Hasta la próxima.